Dear children, this is the story of Prophet Ibrahim, alayhi salam, which is full of excitement and adventure. Ibrahim was still a young man when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him to guide his people. He was clever and very wise, with a strong belief in the one and only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah loved him so much that he named him Khalil Rahman. The people of the village, whom Ibrahim alayhi salam lived with, were idolaters, worshipping statues. But worst of all, Azara, whom was Ibrahim's father, was also an idolater. Not only was he this, but he even made statues himself and was amongst the chiefs of the village. Ibrahim alayhi salam was very upset about this, but went on trying to explain to the people, and especially to his father, about the one true God, Allah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم واذكر في الكتاب إبراهيم إنه كان صديقا نبيا إذ قال لأبيه يا أبت لم تعبد ما لا يسمع ولا يبصر ولا يغني عنك شيئا يا أبت إني قد جاءني من العلم ما لم يأتك فاتبعني أهدك صراطا سويا يا أبت لا تعبد الشيطان إن الشيطان كان للرحمن عصيا يا أبت إني أخاف أن يمسك عذاب من الرحمن فتكون للشيطان وليا قال أراغب أنت عن آلهتي يا إبراهيم لئن لم تنته لأرجمنك واهجرني مليا
One day Ibrahim alayhi salam said to his father, O my father, why worship that which cannot hear you, and cannot see you, and cannot profit you? O my father, to me has come knowledge which has not reached you. So follow me, I will guide you to a way that is even and straight. O my father, serve not Satan, for Satan is a rebel against Allah, most gracious. O my father, I fear that a penalty will harm you, from Allah most gracious, taking Satan as a friend. His father replied, Do you hate my gods, O Ibrahim? If you do not stop, I will indeed stone you. Therefore now keep away from me, for a good long while.
Ibrahim alayhi salam did not give up, but carried on with his people, explaining about the oneness of the true God, Allah, and always proved them wrong. One day, King Nemrud, who was a tyrant, argued with Ibrahim about his Lord. Ibrahim said, My Lord is he who gives life and death. The king said, I give life and death, meaning that he could let a person live or execute them. Of course, this was a fallacy. Ibrahim proposed another question to the king. He said, But it is Allah that causes the sun to rise from the east. Do you then cause it to rise from the west? So the king had no answer and was therefore defeated.
How brave Ibrahim was! One day Ibrahim alayhi salam said, My Lord, show me how you give life to the dead. Allah said, Do you not believe? Ibrahim said, Yes, but so my heart will be contented. Allah said, Take four birds, bring them closer to you, then look at them carefully, then slaughter them, cut them into pieces, and then put a portion of them on every mountain, and call to them. They will come to you, flying with speed. Then know that Allah is exalted in power, wise. And this is exactly what happened.
The people of the village went out to celebrate one of their feasts on this particular day. Ibrahim a.s. went with them, but whilst he was there, he prepared a plan. He said that he was ill, and so he returned back to his village. He went straight to the temple, where all the statues were kept, and this was his chance to give his people a practical lesson. Ibrahim asked the statues, "Why don't you eat?" as there was food placed in front of them. "Why don't you speak?" Then Ibrahim a.s., with his right hand, broke them into pieces, leaving the biggest statue standing there. Their gods could not even defend themselves and were helpless.
When the people returned back from their festival, they went to the temple, but to their horror, they found all their idols shattered into pieces on the floor. They said, "Who has done this to our gods? He must indeed be a wrongdoer. We heard a youth talk of them. He is called Ibrahim," they said. "Bring him before the eyes of the people, that they may bear witness." Said the people, "Are you the one that did this with our gods, O Ibrahim?" "No, it was done by this big one." "Ask them if they can speak," Ibrahim said. So they turned to themselves and said, "Surely we are the ones in the wrong," and were confused and unsure. With shame they said, "You know full well that these idols do not speak." Ibrahim said, "Do you then worship besides Allah things that can neither be of any good to you, nor do you harm? Fie upon you, and upon the things that ye worship, besides Allah. Have you no sense?" Once again they became conceited, and in their conceitedness they said, "Burn him and protect your gods, if you do anything at all." But when they put Ibrahim in the fire, Allah said, "O fire, be thou cool and peace for Ibrahim." Then they sought a plot against him. But Allah said, "We made them the ones that lost most."
Ibrahim a.s. came out of the fire unharmed and thereafter decided to exodus from this village. He, his wife Sarah and his nephew Lut travelled to the land of Eshem. The story of Ibrahim a.s. will continue in part 2 of this series, inshallah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.